Sinclair with the news and his comments on CFRB Toronto.
Gordoin Sinclair's career in radio, television, and newspapers has spanned 61 of his 83 years. The word retirement is obviously not in Sink's vocabulary. While his daily pace has slowed somewhat, he still writes and reads a newscast on CFRB 4 days a week, arriving in his office shortly after 10 a.m. to scan the various wire services and to prepare the unique blend of news and sometimes highly controversial personal opinions on the news. Love him or hate him, almost 200,000 people tune in to his radio newscast. He has been broadcasting since 1942, in most recent years from this high-rise office tower at St. Clair and Young in Midtown Toronto. And one of his daily routines is still having a glass of red wine at a favorite watering hole just across the street. Sink has been taking this stroll for years, occasionally yucking it up with some of the patrons.
Can I get a second opinion here, please?
Well, the wine is a rather simple little wine. I would say that it's rather a peasant type, wouldn't you say? I have a feeling that the grapes were picked maybe a little too soon. Wouldn't you agree?
Sink's early years were spent working in a bank and at other minor jobs. By 1922, he was bored.
And I started the idea of being a reporter, and to my astonishment, I was hired twice on the same day. The Mail and Empire and the Star, both on the same day. But I decided to take the Star because I was working days. I wrote in slang quite a bit, and I still talk in slang, and I think that's useful. It wouldn't be useful if we all slapped it around the way I do, the language, but there's room for one.
Sinclair has always had a love-hate relationship with his fans, but he says that relationship is beginning to change.
The hate stuff is diminishing. Yeah, I've become a lovable old guy now. Don't you know that?
Why do they have that sort of relationship with you, do you think?
I think it's because I don't back up. For example, you reach an unpopular stand, and you say it, and then you get a lot of phone calls and mail and so on and so on. They kind of expect you to back down. Well, I don't. I go back at it again. And I think there's a certain amount of admiration for that stand. If I think I'm right, I'm going to say so.
The outspoken broadcaster who has worked with Ernest Hemingway, talked to world leaders like Hitler, Gandhi, and more recently U.S. President Ronald Reagan, is no longer traveling the globe, but he still makes occasional jaunts to the provincial capitals for tapings of the nationally televised Front Page Challenge. A good portion of his time, however, is now spent here, at his home of 50 years in Islington. He says he does not want to write another book. He wrote 10, of which 9 were published, and 3 actually made him money. All of them were about his travels around the world. As for continuing to work on an almost daily basis, he says he set a goal, but he's not sure he can achieve it.
I'd like to finish out my contract if I can, and that runs until my 85th birthday. Now, Lowell Thomas made it to 85, but lately my legs have been bothering me, and so I may not make it. The alternative here is not very good. What would I do, sit around and feel sorry for myself?
Gordoin Sinclair has always been well known for putting people on the spot, on the air, by asking them how much money they make. Well, Hourlong could not let the opportunity go by. We put the question to Gordoin Sinclair.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you asked that. My income last year was somewhere around $290,000. And my assets I don't reveal because I have never asked any man, woman, or child, living or dead, how much money they have or ever did have or how much assets in any form they have. But about income, yes. I something between $200,000 and $300,000, and about half of that comes to investments. And I am one of the few in our field, that is the radio and broadcast and entertainment field, that has that big an income and is not incorporated as a company. I am Gordoin Sinclair, and I pay my tax as my individual person at the full rate.
By the way, Gordoin Sinclair paid almost $110,000 in taxes last year.
And we'll be back to...